Welcome to the seventh lecture of the course Metrology and Machine Tools. In this lecture, I will explain about the lathe operations. Lathe operations, first one is plane turning, step turning and taper turning, facing, parting, drilling, reaming, boring, knurling, grooving, threading and forming. These are some operations you can perform on the lathe machine. Along with these operations, we can perform the grinding, gear cutting and milling operations also. But for those operations, we need some lathe attachments. Then I will see one by one. First one is a plane turning. Plane turning is the operation of removing excess amount of material from the surface of a cylindrical job. Here we are removing the excess amount of material from the surface of the workpiece. We are going to remove the material from the throughout the surface of the workpiece. Let's see, for example, here this is a workpiece and the diameter of the workpiece is 10 mm. Diameter of the workpiece is 10 mm. So we are going to remove some material. Let's say, for example, we are going to remove some 2 mm of material from the diameter and we are going to maintain the diameter of finished object as 8 mm. So we are going to remove 2 mm of material from the throughout the surface of the workpiece. By removing the 2 mm, we are maintaining 8 mm of finished object. So this is about the plane turning operation. The next one is step turning. Step turning is an operation performed on the lathe machine where the excess material is removed from the workpiece to obtain various steps of different diameters. Here, if the basic diameter of the workpiece is some 10 mm, by removing the material, we are maintaining different steps of different diameters. Let's see, if you observe, the diameter of this step is some 8 mm, and the diameter of this step is 6 mm. You can take it as 6 mm. That means by removing the material from the workpiece, we are maintaining the different diameters. You can call it as the different steps. So that is called as a step turning. If you observe this video here, this is the basic diameter 10 mm and we are removing the material. So up to some part is a 6 mm diameter and this one is the 8 mm diameter. So we are forming some steps on the surface of the workpiece. That's why it is called as a step turning. Next one is taper turning. When the diameter of the workpiece changes uniformly from one end to the other end, the piece is said to be tapered. If the diameter is changed from one end to the other end, you can call it as a tapered surface. So the taper turning is an operation of producing a conical surface. Producing a conical surface by gradual reduction in the diameter of a cylindrical workpiece. So we are maintaining some, we are forming some conical surface on the external surface of the workpiece. This is the taper turning attachment and this is a workpiece. So let's say, for example, this is the same 10 mm diameter of the workpiece. And this one, the diameter of this workpiece at one end is some 6 mm. So from 10 mm to 6 mm, the diameter is gradually decreasing. So this alpha you can call it as a taper angle. So by removing the excess amount of material, we are maintaining some conical surfaces. So that's why it's called as a taper turning operation. We are forming some taper surfaces on the surface. Next one is parting. Parting uses a blade-like cutting tool plugged directly into the workpiece to cut off the workpiece at a specific length. Here we are going to cut the workpieces at a specified length. It is normally used to remove the finished end of workpiece from the bar stock that is clamped in the chuck. After completion of some operation, let's see if you observe this one. I made some operation at on this workpiece. After completion of the operation, I want to separate this finished product from the base material. To separate that finished product, we are going to use the parting operation. If you observe here, by using this cutting tool, we are removing some finished parts. Here, we are removing the workpieces from the base metal. So that is called as a parting of operation. Next one is a facing operation. Facing is the process of removing metal from the end of the workpiece to produce the flat surface. The intention of this facing is to produce the flat surfaces. Here we are removing the material from the end face of the workpiece. So if you observe, by removing the material, you can observe, by removing the metal, we are going to make this end surface as a flat. This is a facing operation. So before producing any, before starting any operations, so first of all, you have to do the facing operation. Next one is the drilling. We know that drilling is the operation of producing a cylindrical holes in the workpiece. So you can perform the drilling operation on lathe machine also. Here, the drill bit is going to be fixed in a tailstock and the workpiece is held in a chuck. So the workpiece is going to be revolving. In this case, the workpiece is going to be revolving and we are going to move this drill bit towards the rotating workpiece, towards the rotating workpiece by moving the tailstock. We are moving the cutting tool towards the rotating workpiece. So this is about the drilling operation. So you can observe, we are moving the drill bit towards the rotating workpiece and the material is removed from the workpiece. This is about the drilling operation. And reaming. Reaming operation, it is called as a finishing operation. You can finish the holes which are already drilled by the drilling operation in the workpiece. So this is a reamer. Just like the drill bit, we are going to fix the reamer and where the workpiece is held in a chuck. Workpiece is going to be rotating and we are going to move the reamer towards the rotating workpiece. Boring operation. So boring operation is the process of analyzing a hole which is already produced by the drilling. So already we discussed about this boring operation. Now here, same, just like the drilling, the workpiece is going to be held in a chuck and we are going to move the boring bit towards the rotating workpiece. In generally, if you go for the drilling, reaming and boring operation, if you want to perform the same operation on the drilling machine, so you are going to use the drilling machine to produce the holes. In the drilling machine, the cutting tool is going to be rotating and the workpiece is going to be kept constant. We are going to move the rotating cutting tool towards the workpiece. But here, in the lathe operation, the workpiece is going to be rotating and we are going to move the cutting tool towards the rotating workpiece. Only the relative motion is going to be changes. So we can perform the operation. Next one is the knurling. Knurling is the process of embossing a diamond shaped or straight line pattern into the surface of the workpiece. Embossing of the diamond shape or knurling shape. Straight line shape. So this is about the knurling and this is the workpiece. And this is the knurling bit. So you can observe this one. You can emboss the or you can impress the whatever the shape you want required on the external surface of the workpiece. This shape is going to be based on the shape or the pattern of this workpiece is going to depends upon the knurling tool. This is the knurling operation. You can impress any pattern on the given workpiece. Next, grooving. So grooving is the act of making grooves of reduced diameter in the workpiece. So if you observe here, we are going to make some reduced diameter. You can call it as a slots. We are going to make some slots on the given workpieces. If you observe this one here, you can observe here we are making some slots by removing some material. This is about the grooving operation. Next one, threading. Threading is the act of cutting the required form of threads on the internal or external cylindrical surface. So cutting the required threads, required form of threads on the external internal, you can do the threading operation on the lathe machine also. Here this is the workpiece and this is the threads. These are the threads, external threads. Depends upon the type of thread, we are going to use the cutting tool. Here we are forming the V threads, that's why I am going to use the V tool, threading V tool, V thread tool we are going to use. We are move the cutting tool, or we can move the workpiece also. Here you can observe how the threads are formed and this distance. So here the material is removed from the workpiece. Based on the type of thread, we can use the cutting tool. Here we are using, we are forming the V thread, that's why I use the V type of cutting tool. So step by step we can remove. We can remove the material from the workpiece to form the V threads. Here you can observe the thread is forming on the cutting tool, workpiece. So like this you can perform the threading operation on the lathe machine. Forming operation. Forming is an operation that produces a convex, concave or any irregular profile on the workpiece. So if you want to perform any irregular operations, so let's say if you observe, if I need convex shape or any concave form or any, so depends upon the shape. First of all, you have to manufacture the cutting, you have to select the cutting tool. So if you want to perform any irregular profiles, so that called is a forming operation. Here is a contour turning. So if you observe, you can perform this operation. So here, these are some examples of the forming operation. That means you can do any operation on the lathe machine. You can perform any shape on the workpieces by using the lathe machine. Next one is a chamfering. Chamfering is the operation of getting a beveled surface at the edge of a cylindrical workpiece. Here at the edge, if I need some bevel shape, so we are going to use the chamfering. The purpose of chamfering is used to remove the sharp edges at the end of the surfaces to make the handling safe. Here initially it is a sharp edge. We are going to remove that sharp edge. We are going to form some bevel shape here like this. We are going to form some bevel shape, which is used for the, you can handle the object very safely. You can observe. So you can handle the object very safely. For that one, we are going to make the end surfaces as a beveled shape. That is called as a chamfering. So these are the lathe operations. See, this is a straight turning, taper turning, and profiling. You can call it as a forming operation. Profile means we can perform any, we can get any profile on the given workpiece. This is a turning and facing, grooving, drilling, boring, and cutting a thread, and parting off or cutting off. So knurling operation. These are the operations you can perform on the lathe machine. In addition to these operations, you can perform grinding, milling, and taper turning. Different operations you can perform